subscribe to my channel and press bell icon for latest updates. Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Vikram. In this class, we will try to understand double linked list. So far in our previous videos, 3 to 4 videos, we tried to understand what is meant by a single linked list. So a single linked list is used for the implementation of the lists. In the similar way, double linked list is also used for the implementation of the list. But the difference between a single linked list and a double linked list is the way in which it is getting implemented. So that is the difference. Even though both of them are used to implement lists, but each and every one is having its own importance in understanding. So now we will try to understand the working mechanism of double linked list, and we will try to differentiate between the single linked list and double linked list. But we are not going to give the algorithms for double linked list and also for the circular linked list, which we are going to discuss in our next video. So we want you to practice. So we want you to construct the algorithm for the double linked list, in this class we will try to understand the insertion of a node in the middle of the double linked list. So what we suggest is, you please, with the understanding of the single linked list, if you are directly coming to this video and you haven't watched the videos on single linked list, please go there and watch the videos on the single linked list. So with the understanding of the single linked list, you try to construct your own algorithm on double linked list, where the insertion and deletion has to be done in the middle of the double linked list. So for that, you have to construct the algorithm and you have to write the program for double linked list. So for better understanding, watch the videos on single linked list. So in single linked list, we have discussed about the insertion at the start, insertion at the end, and insertion at the middle. All the 3 points of single linked list were detailedly covered in our previous videos. So please go there and watch those videos if you are directly coming here for the understanding of double linked list. So now in this video, we will try to understand the mechanism of the double linked list, where the insertion and deletion is done in the middle of the double linked list. So that we will try to understand. So what is the difference between single linked list and double linked list is, it is the node. So the node that we have used in the single linked list is the structure that is used for the construction of the node in a single linked list. So if you recap, the knowledge on the understanding on single linked list, we have used this as the structure. So if you remember or recollect the things, struct node star next. So this is the structure of the single linked list, structure of the node in the single linked list that we have seen in our previous classes. So what is the difference is, in the double linked list, the structure of the node is going to vary. So what the difference between the single linked list structure and the double linked list structure is, we are going to add one more pointer. So this is what we call it as a self-referential structure. So this is also a self-referential structure, but it consists of 2 pointers. One pointer points to the previous node, and the other pointer points to the next node. Whereas in the single linked list, we have used only one pointer in which we call it as a self-referential structure. So in this structure, we used only one pointer, which is pointing to the next node. So the basic difference between a single linked list and the double linked list is, an extra pointer is added, which points to its previous node. So what's the difference is, double linked list makes our traversal within the list very easy. So why it is making our traversal easy means, we can move front and back. We can move next to the next node and the previous node on a single, using a single pointer, using a single node's address, we can move to the previous node and also we can move to the next node. So whereas in our understanding on single linked list, with the insertion and deletion at the middle of the middle of the list, we have used two pointers. So the one pointer is pointing to the previous node and the other is pointing to the next node or the current node. So with the double linked list, those two pointers, using those two pointers are not required, are not required, but in which is not required in a double linked list. So now we'll try to understand the structure. So these are the pointers. So these are the two pointers that we are trying to use. These two pointers, one name is prev and the next one is next. So these pointers are capable of storing the address of the node, which is of type structure. So the address of the structure called node can be stored in this space. So in our visualization for the single linked list, we said that this is the node. This is the node where we are going to store the value here, and the pointer for the next node will get stored in this. While coming to the point of double linked list, the visualization is going to change, because we have three variables. This is value and this is next. So which is pointing to the next node, and this one is previous node. So which is pointing to its previous node. So that makes the difference between a single linked list and a double linked list. What happens in the single linked list is we can traverse only in the forward direction. Once we crossed a node, and it is not possible for us to come back unless otherwise we use another pointer to point to the previous node. So in our previous examples, we have used temp prev. So temp prev is a variable which is maintaining the address of the previous node, whereas in the case of double linked list, that temporary variable is not required. So here we are having a facility called prev, another pointer called prev, which is pointing to its previous node, and we also have another pointer called next in the same node, which is pointing to the next node. So that is the benefit of a double linked list. That makes the difference between a single linked list from the double linked list, where the traversal in the front to traversal to the front and to the back can be made easily. So now we will try to construct now we will try to understand this double linked list using an example, and we will try to insert and delete a node from the middle. Okay, so now how this double linked list can be constructed is head. So use our standard definitions of the node. So here we have okay, let's catch up this. This is not so this is the way in which a single link, a double linked list will get constructed for the insertion and deletion of the element at the start. So this is going to be 100, which is the head node's address, will get stored in head. So what this starting node, the previous node of the head is. So are there any elements previous to the head node, previous to the first node? So any other node which is existing before before this head node, there are no elements. So what we have to do is, for the first element, the prev is going to be 0. So the value stored in it is 10, and the next node is going to be 200. So the next node that we are trying to point to is going to be 200, and in the 200 at the prev place it is going to have. So this is the prev, this is the value and this is next. So for every node we are going to have these variables val and next. So these are the variables that are used in the structure. So it is prev, value and next. So this is the shape of the structure. So on the memory, this kind of structure will get constructed. So this is the visualization for of the memory for the structure called node, which is used in double linked list. So this is going to be 20 and the address of the next is going to be 300. So the address of the previous is going to be 200, and this is pointing here, and the value stored here is 30, and for this it is going to be 400 because the next node's address is 400. So this is the address of next node, and the value stored here is 40, and the previous node's address is going to be 300. And what is the address that needs to be stored for the next, for the value of next in the last node? In the last node, at the value of next, what we have to store? What we have to store is null, because there are no elements existing after the last node, so we have to point it to null. Okay, so this previous is going to be here and next is pointing there, and this previous is pointing to 100. So this is the pointing, and this 200 is pointing to its next node. So this is the way in which a double linked list can be constructed. Okay, now we will try to understand, if we try to insert the element in the middle, how we have to change the pointers, how we have to change the structure of this double linked list. So that we will try to understand. Now I am trying to insert a node with address 350, and I want to insert 35 in between. Because the elements are inserted in the middle, the nodes are inserted in the middle, which means that we are trying to insert, which may say that we are trying to insert the elements in the increasing order. So if we try to insert this node on here, what are the changes that we have to make so that the list can be constructed in an efficient way? So what we have to do is, this address, the 350 is going to be inserted between 300 and 400. Between these two nodes, this node has to be inserted. So we have to change the values in these pointers, and also the values in this ought to be inserted very carefully, so that the link between the nodes has to be maintained efficiently. So for that, what we have to do is, so we have to change this to 350, because the next node for this node is going to be this node, because the new insertion is going to be this. Okay, so that, because the new insertion is going to be this node, it is going to be inserted between these two nodes. So for that, what we have to do is, we have to change this address value to 350 and this address value to 300, because the previous node for this node is going to be this node. Okay, so now how the links between for this node and this node has to be established is, it has to be stored with 400, because the next node for this node is going to be this node, and the previous node for this is going to be 350. It is no more 300, because the insertion is done between 300 and 350. So the previous node for this is going to be this one. So these are the links that needs to be maintained. These are the steps that you have to construct for every possible condition. As we have understood clearly the way in which the steps are constructed for single linked list, those conditions are only used for the double linked list also. But the difference is, we have to manage this prev, next and all that conditions. The steps are going to be more in every condition, and you should be very careful so that the links between the nodes can be established in an efficient way without any mistakes. Okay, so this is the way in which a double linked list, a node can be inserted into a double linked list in the middle. So now if you try to delete a node from the double linked list. So for example, if we try to delete this node from the double linked list, how the pointers in the double linked list has to be changed, how this prev and how this next and prev has to be changed. So that we have to understand if you want to delete a node from the middle of a double linked list. So if we try to delete this double link, this node, what we have to do is, so its next value, 300's next value has to be 400, because this is no more existing, and this value has to be changed to 300 and this has to be freed. Okay, if we free this, so now the new link that are established with the changes that we have made so far. Okay, so now what's happening is this is pointing to 400 and this is pointing to 300. Okay, so that is the way in which the steps in the conditions are to be maintain. So you think of yourself, try to construct the algorithm, after that try to write the program for double linked list and also the circular linked list that we are trying to discuss, that we will try to discuss in our next video. Hope you understood how the double linked list works. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates.